report into home loan affordability has been released this morning, showing the biggest improvement in 18 months. Well, to explain why that is and who will benefit is Bernard Hickey from interest.co.nz. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Good to have you here. Home loan affordability, basically what we're looking at is interest rates, house prices and wages, and the planets have aligned.
Yes, we've seen an improvement in the Roost Home Loan Affordability Report to the best level since September last year. Mm. That's because of a fall in fixed mortgage rates, a drop in house prices and a slight improvement in incomes. So a bit of a surprise really, because the housing market has been tough for a lot of people to get into in previous years because house prices were so high, particularly in the main centres. But house prices have started to drop, according to the REINZ, and some economists expect it to fall a bit further. And also surprisingly, fixed mortgage rates have dropped in the last 6 weeks or so.
It is surprising, given that we have seen the Reserve Bank bump up the OCR.
Yes, it's a strange one, this one. We've got the official cash rate rising, but fixed mortgage rates falling, because people are concerned about the global economy, how fast the economy will grow, and the inflation outlook is a bit more subdued. And the Reserve Bank reflected that too. So that means that longer-term interest rates don't seem to be rising so much. In fact, they're falling. And that's good for home loan affordability for those people who take out fixed mortgages.
Mm. Now, who's this particularly good for? First home buyers, people who are looking to, you know, to get into the market?
Those people who are looking to get into the market, first home buyers, have been a bit quiet recently. But with affordability improving, particularly in the regions and outside of the main centres, you can now, if you've got a couple of incomes, get into a house for, you know, 20, 30% of your disposable income. So there is an improvement there, and that's good news.
How does this compare to, say, 2 years ago when home loan affordability was not so healthy?
Yeah, it was really tough, particularly towards the end of 2007, early 2008. Remember when house prices were at their peak and interest rates were nearly 10%. But we've seen a real improvement in the last couple of years. When house prices bounced a bit last year and interest rates, people thought they were going to start increasing, we saw a bit of a deterioration. But it's actually improved in the last 6 months or so, and it's really, we've seen the biggest improvement in 18 months in July, which is good news.
Which is good. There is a bit of a feeling that people are really holding back from purchasing houses at the moment. Is this a good time to go forward?
Well, affordability is really important, and your view on where interest rates are headed. If you think interest rates are going to stay low for longer, and that's what the markets are saying at the moment,
then you can sit for a while.
Yes, and you can see that your costs will be reasonably contained. And when you see house prices falling, and commentators are saying that it's a buyer's market, then some people will say, hey, I'm confident that interest rates will stay low, and I can see that I've got the power when I'm buying a house, so maybe it's a good time to get in.
It is a nice position to be in, though, isn't it, to have, the balls in your court. On that side, though, who is this bad for?
Well, obviously, if you're a homeowner and you're a little bit worried about house prices falling, that's one to watch. And if you're a little bit stressed, maybe you've got a mortgagee sale or an estate sale or a home breakup or whatever, that can be tough. We're in a tough market for home sellers at the moment because the power is with the buyer. And although when you have an improvement in affordability, in places in particular like Queenstown, which has just lost its mantle as the most expensive place in the country for the first time in 8 years.
8 years since 2002. Auckland is now the most expensive place to live in the country.
It is particularly tough in central Auckland to get in. And in fact, there's a bit of a microclimate developing in Auckland where established houses, because of the leaky homes problem, are quite short of supply, and there's plenty of demand around. So we're seeing prices in very central Auckland actually rising and a bit stronger than many people had expected. So that's making it tough for anyone who thinks they want to start off in central Auckland. Affordability is tougher there.
Yeah, no, starting off in central Auckland, I think, is beyond most people, isn't it? Bernard, thanks very much for joining us this morning. Bernard Hickey from interest.co.nz.